How does the thinking stuff that we were talking about and just starting apply to some other businesses, either that you've seen other people run or that you've been involved in yourself?
Well, we have all of these marvelous stories that you end up seeing on television, you know, on the Bloomberg specials about entrepreneurs, et cetera, so forth. And it's like these ideas kind of came out of the thin air, or people have been working these ideas for years. You know, Starbucks, in reality, was born out of the 1,465 customers who really didn't like Howard Schultz's first venture, Il Giornale.
Right, tell us that story. That's a great story.
And so the reality of that is, when you look at a place like Starbucks, everybody visualizes, by the time the books were all done, it was, you know, this man had this deep passion for creating an authentic Italian espresso bar in the United States. And so he went off from Seattle to Italy and had a vision, and Starbucks was born. And the reality is, like many of us, this was an entrepreneur who actually cared deeply about coffee, who actually developed a robust business plan at a terrible time in the market for actually being able to attract funds for coffee, because coffee was experiencing 20 years of its market share declines, and that in fact cola beverages becoming the preferred source of caffeination for young people at this point in time. So it's not the time to start a sophisticated coffee business,
right.
But by George, he was absolutely committed to it. In Just New, Nancy Kane, a historian, documented that he took this business plan to 252 people, and the vast majority of them thought it was completely idiotic.
No,
so he
you.
Couldn't raise anywhere near the amount of money that he had fantasized would be required to get started in this grand vision of what happened. So he started something much smaller. He started a chain called Il Giornale, a chain, one unit chain. It had nonstop opera music. It had a menu that was completely in Italian. It had baristas wearing tuxedo outfits. It was really authentic in all of those respects. But because he couldn't raise enough money, it was stand-up. You know, so when you think about the dimensions of Starbucks today as the third place with comfortable seating,
right.
You know, its progenitor, Il Giornale, wasn't anything like that. So what did he discover the first 5 days? You know what? People, by and large, they might like opera in the moment, but a mass population doesn't want opera from open to close.
Right.
No one could have predicted, who in their right mind could have predicted that Americans, and now a global population, would prefer to learn a completely artificial language.
It's true.
Okay, rather than speak Italian. Okay, so no one wanted to go into this place and have to speak Italian to order authentic beverages. And quite honestly, when you pay that much money for a cup of espresso-based beverage, you really don't want to stand. Okay, particularly
right.
If you're coming to and from work, or you'd like to have a